Just in general.
In general, in your space in life right now, how do you feel?
I feel good, I guess. It's like a very weird feeling being in a different body size, but I feel fine.
You look fine.
Rest unto your souls.
I'm looking forward to new adventures, new changes, mental states, all of that. Memories. I can honestly say my 20s was rough because I was the fat girl. I was the token duff in the group, so it was really difficult to try to, you know, be confident in who I was or who I am, knowing that, you know, they're just hanging out with me to be nice because I'm sweet, not because they see something in me. I'm just the girl that's there because I'm funny, or I offer, you know, photography, or I'm just, oh, well, when I need something, I know that Brittany will come through kind of thing. Like, now people can start to treat me how I treat myself, and that's with love, care, generosity, tenderness. Like, the fact that people are now offering themselves to me, it's a different kind of feeling, like,
yeah.
And I like that. I want to see that more in the
awesome. What's the first thing you're going to do
when I turn 30?
When you turn 30,
eat. Right. I'm gonna find me a piece of pound cake with no sugar, no dairy, no nothing, something, and I'm gonna eat.
Okay,
I'm just playing. I'm probably gonna pray and cry, but first, pray. I'll be in St. Louis, so I'll probably like sneak off in the hotel bathroom and like pray real quick.
That's dope. I'll probably be there with you. It's not those praying. Where's the first place that you want to visit?
I actually want to go to Texas. I have been saying that I wanted to go to Texas. Everybody always says, oh, where are you going? Texas? Always wanted to go to Texas, so I think that it's time that I visit Houston, Texas.
Okay.
At some point.
And last question. What impact do you want to leave for the year 30?
I think I want to inspire people to be unapologetic and just love the skin that they're in. I know that that's weird coming from somebody who is super self-conscious and somebody who still has their moments of being self-conscious, but I think that it's really important that Black women especially love themselves, because honestly, who's gonna do it for us? You know, we have to be that lover, that person for ourselves and show up. And I think that I never understood what self-love really meant or what showing up for yourself meant until I had to show up for myself in moments where I couldn't articulate, like, this is what I'm going through, this is what hurts, this is how I feel, you know. And people can relate to you, but no one can be in your shoes and say, this is how you feel, or I can register with you 100%. You can't, because you didn't go through what I went through when I was 5 or 4 or 16 or 18. Like, you just came into understanding, you know, oh, you went through this and so did I. But yeah, your past, you know, includes sunshine and rainbows, and mine was like dark times, clouds, rain, you know, a lot of dark moments. And although our feelings about the situation and circumstances may be similar, you know, our moment of understanding is similar, it's not the same. And I think that when you can show up for yourself, when you can advocate for yourself, you know, love on yourself, pray for yourself, it attracts other people to want to do the same. And I just want to inspire and empower women, especially Black women, to just be unapologetic.
I think you're doing a hell of a job already. You surpassed a lot of people even older than you, so that's an accomplishment that you've already reached before 30, so.
Oh,
amazing.
I have a great husband that pours into me.
He pours into me, just pours into me. Mm-hmm. And I'm ready for you to embrace exactly who you are. I'm scared of it at the same time.
You're gonna be crying.
Am I gonna be crying? Oh,
yeah, so you're gonna have me crying, is that what we're doing?
I would hope that you don't cry, because you ugly cry. I ain't trying to deal
don't
with that.
It.
But it's an honor to be a husband, it really is. And I'm just happy for this evolution that I get to witness personally. So that's it. I didn't want to take all your time. Is there anything else you want to say to people that are following you or that will follow you soon?
Not besides thank you. That's literally all I can say is thank you, because it's overwhelming every single day. I literally wake up to messages of people telling me how much I inspire them. And I used to be the person sending the messages to random people like, oh my God, you inspire me. You helped me get through my marriage. You helped me get through my life. And now I'm the person that gets like 50 to 100 messages a day on several platforms, from YouTube, my personal Instagram, my community Instagram, our Instagram, Facebook, my personal Facebook, like it, TikTok, like we get it everywhere, of just women being inspired. And it's crazy that God used my mess and turned it into like something beautiful that I'm still trying to process and figure out. Like, what are you doing? How did you turn my chaos into something that can minister to women?
Yeah.
I've stopped trying to figure it out. I'm just walking in that ministry, but I'm grateful that I am inspiring to people, me and my basic self.
I love it. I love you.
I love you more. So dramatic.
Yeah, dream come true.
Yes.